have to say, I get tired of following trends. When it comes to my house and my style in general, I want something that's comfy and cozy, changes a little bit from time to time, just so it doesn't get boring, and has a fairly good balance of modern and rustic. That's my personal style. So instead of following design styles and techniques that come and go each year, I've decided that I'm going to go with a nature-inspired interior design style. I figure I can never go wrong with this style because nature should always be present in my life anyways. It keeps me grounded. This is what I call a Shizen style, or a natural style. Nature's continuous, yet never the same, making it the best place to gather ideas for decorating your home and creating a seamless flow throughout the different rooms in your house. I hope I can inspire you to create your own calm yet exciting place to live. There's a lot of research nowadays that shows that being in nature relieves stress, helps you focus, boosts creativity, and does a number of other things to your mind and body that have long-lasting positive effects. At Shizen Style, I aim to blend contemporary natural designs that help create both a relaxing yet exciting lifestyle. Bringing nature inside is a key part to this natural interior design style. So the first thing to focus on is staying in tune with the seasons. An important part to a nature-inspired interior design is that you realize that nature is not static. To truly appreciate the seasons and to connect with the world outside, you need to create a design element inside that reflects the current outside condition. Every season can be appreciated for its own beauty, and this is something that you should strive to find joy and harmony with. In the Northeast, we're blessed with the beauty of the four seasons, and I love to bring elements of the current season into the interior design. This is different from decorating for the holidays. Decorating for the season may be much more subtle than large holiday themes, but in the warmer months, do a little research to see what grows locally at that time of year. This could be both vegetables as well as flowers that are blooming, grasses, the color of leaves, etc. Winter has its own beauties, which can be highlighted with simple things like pines, juniper, holly, dried branches, etc. The next thing you want to pay attention to is natural sunlight. One of the best ways to create a nature-inspired interior design is to allow natural sunlight in. You may not be able to adjust your architecture, but if you have the opportunity, the larger the windows that you can get, the better. This can also be accomplished with extra wide glass siding doors and skylights. Being able to see outside and see the current weather condition brings a sense of harmony with you and the outside. Natural sunlight can brighten a room and also create interesting shadows. Without the dark, there'd be no light. Therefore, shadows allow us to appreciate these bright spots. There's even a famous Japanese piece of literature called In Praise of Shadows, but I encourage you to read it if you're interested in this discussion of natural lighting and shadowing. Yes, creating shadows can be an art form in itself. If you're in the city, possibly next to a building, or just don't have a view of nature outside, a skylight may be a good option. It allows you to bring a lot of light in without having to give up wall space either. Solid glass walls are a nice idea for some, but also eliminate being able to hang things on the walls and make it more difficult for shelving. In Japan, where it's very crowded and often houses are very close to each other, they have developed architectural styles that still employed large glass windows and doors, but feature a solid wall in front of the window outside. This may be 50 feet away from the glass, or if they're in a tighter space, even 10 feet or 5 feet, you can still create a small garden right in front of the window that lets a lot of that light in. Usually this wall can serve as a nice backdrop for a simple garden, even if it's very close to the house. You can have some simple plantings that get highlighted with a solid white or black background from the wall or fence, which also lets a lot of natural lighting in. Raw materials and handmade items are great for allowing natural elements into your interior design. A lot of natural wooden furniture can really bring the raw nature into even a contemporary setting. You're seeing many things like tree stumps as tables, live wood slab tables, and thick lumber cup benches. Our beams are original hand cut, most likely from a nearby tree. You don't want to clutter the area, but having a few original handmade items allows you to appreciate the connection between human beings and nature. This item becomes the room's statement piece and a talking point with guests. Handmade crafts or works of art allow you to appreciate the beauty of raw nature and a human being's creativity. Our natural hand-cut beams from most likely a nearby tree from when the house was originally built over 100 years in our living room, these beams go all the way across, spanning 50 feet, and the shadows that they create along the ceiling is just, it's beautiful. And then seeing the natural texture of all the shadows from the hand cuts really adds a unique element to the space. Natural stone being used inside can also bring a very down-to-earth feeling to the room. There's some natural slate floors that you could install and include stones and pebbles in a bathroom design, for example. We have a very large hearth, a large fireplace with some unique, it's built with stone. And then above that, we have, again, another piece of that hand-cut timber. So adding texture and the subtleties of that and the shadows that play off of that are really nice. Another thing to look at is nature-inspired pottery and ceramics. Part of your interior design can also be made up of natural pottery and ceramics. Dinnerware and kitchenware that have more earth tone colors or lighter pastel colors and also have a slightly rougher natural texture to them can really have a calming feeling when you eat. It allows you to appreciate the food better, I think. Again, if these items are handmade or original, you also get that deeper connection between art and nature. I love smaller terrariums where you can sort of create a whole mini garden scene in a small space. They make some of these terrariums in glass balls that sometimes even have a string to hang them on. What's nice about the terrariums is that you can get to see the dirt or maybe sand in the bottom of the plant as well, reminding you of the whole process of nature and growing. Traditional pots only show you the outcome of what has taken place underground in the dirt. But the glass allows you to see all of nature, but still in a refined, clean vessel. Indoor plants, of course, can be one of the easier ways to bring nature inside, but be careful with the indoor plants because they can often distract you from the current season. Many indoor plants in the Northeast are more tropical plants or something from down south and that thrive in warmer zones than what you would naturally find in this area. Therefore, part of my philosophy is with staying in tune with the seasons and having bright flowering tropical plants in January just isn't a natural occurrence in some places like New York. So if it were me, I tend to stick with darker greens and something like an aloe plant maybe. In Japan, they have these small moss balls called kokedama. These kokedama moss balls are wrapped in twine that keep them together, but also often have a very small growing flower or a maple tree, for example, growing out of them. And sometimes they're placed on a piece of wood or natural pottery, and they also helps to create a miniaturized nature scene. There are a lot of different floral arrangements that can be used to highlight the seasons. If you were looking for some inspiration, try having a look at the Japanese art of floral arrangement known as ikebana. Different schools of ikebana have different philosophies, some being very bold and artistic, and others being more subdued, minimalist, and creative in a way that aligns with the concept of wabi-sabi, or the appreciation of the beauty of imperfection. If you'd like to explore the Japanese aesthetic concept of wabi-sabi, please check out my playlist on wabi-sabi. No matter what season you're in, have a walk outside and look around for small items that you might be able to forage and use as nature-inspired decor. These items could go in a nice vase that could be displayed near the entryway, around the dining table, or could simply be displayed alone on a wall or a bookshelf. This can be a combination of branches, grasses, flowers. A dead branch with many interesting curves and straight lines can really be a thing of beauty. Living walls and green walls can also be another way to create a nature-inspired interior. Even in tight city areas or in an apartment, you can add a very artistic piece of greenery. This could be a wide variety of different colors that create something very bright, vibrant, or it could be the same color with different patterns or squares on the wall to make it interesting. Different green wall or living wall systems have a variety of different ways to water them also. Another part of natural decor is making use of images of nature instead of actual nature. Artwork can be very creative, and actual photographs of nature can really allow you to bring yourself to a different area. I find that I can appreciate natural landscape scenes that is blown up and I know was the work of a photographer working with natural elements in nature. I find it more difficult to appreciate a natural landscape scene on wallpaper though. I tend to like a poster size or maybe even something smaller of a photograph or even wallpaper, but when you know the whole wall is blown out, for example, of a white birch forest, it just seems to be trying a little too hard and a little unnatural for the room. Your home may or may not have a fireplace, and sometimes merely having chopped wood stacked up can give you the image or impression of a fireplace. And fireplaces seem to represent a place in nature, like a log cabin, for example, where you can relax from the everyday stresses of life. If you have an actual wood-burning fireplace, or maybe a pellet type of modern style fireplace, the stacked up logs next to the fireplace may just be the ideal inspired piece of nature that you need. Even if your fireplace doesn't work, just displaying firewood in the fireplace can give a similar satisfying ambiance. Modern gas and electric fireplaces now also create a very natural feeling with the flames and the heat given off. Allowing yourself to be surrounded by the natural elements causes you to relax and also realize that you're part of something much bigger than just yourself. Studies have shown that taking a walk in nature greatly helps your creativity. When you relax and you let the stress go, your mind can naturally connect the dots and bring together different realizations that you're unable to see when you're busy or stressed out. As much as possible, you should aim to create this type of calming environment inside the home. Blurring the lines of nature within the home and outside, you can recreate a place of peacefulness and calmness, and it can do wonders for your mind, body, and spirit. I hope this guide to nature-inspired interior design was helpful in showing you that there are nature inspirations in every season. I really believe in this concept of modern and rustic design living in harmony with each other, highlighting each other's beautiful imperfections. If you'd like to go deeper on building a contemporary and natural lifestyle, please subscribe to Shizen Style, and I'll see you in my next video.